think of the goodness of Jesus and all he has done for me. You know my soul cries out, hallelujah. I praise God for saving me. Oh, when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all he has done for me, you know my soul cries out, hallelujah. I praise God for saving me. I praise God for saving me. I praise God for saving me. Oh, when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all he has done for me, you know my soul cries out, hallelujah. Praise God for saving me. Amen. Praise the Lord, everybody. Certainly we do give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good and his mercy endureth forever. We thank and praise the Lord that he's worthy. He's worthy to be praised. And I don't just say those words lightly. Oftentimes we can say things and we say them so often that we take what we're saying not at the depths of what we're saying, and we can take it for granted. But when we think about all that the Lord has done and his awesome splendor and his awesome wonder, as the song says, how great thou art. Amen. And if you just allow your soul to meditate and your mind to think about how great he is, your soul will cry out, hallelujah. And you can praise God for salvation. We certainly want to go before the Lord in prayer. We honor our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, from whom all of our blessings flow. Amen. There's no other name given under heaven whereby men must be saved other than that of Jesus Christ. And we certainly, Jesus often told those that if you believe on me, you can have eternal life. If you just believe the words which I have spoken unto you. And we certainly believe. And he said, if you don't believe me, my words, and he said, just believe me for the work's sake. Amen. The things that he has done in our lives. If we look to look back as an individual over our lifestyle and our lifespan, the Lord has done some great things. The Lord has done some mighty things. And if we were to look back over that, our soul can truly say that the Lord is real. Jesus is real. He's real to us. And as he has said in his word, he'd never leave us nor forsake us. And he's been true to his word. And if we were to itemize it, we would come up with the same conclusion, that the Lord is good and the Lord is true to his word. So as we get ready to go before the Lord in prayer, we certainly do want to remember, amen, the ability of Christ and the power of our prayer as we begin to call on the name of the Lord and make our request known unto the Lord. We certainly want to pray for Sister Monique and pray for Brother Jamil, Sister Stephanie Arrington, son, that the Lord will bless them and encourage and strengthen them, and bless Daniel's family. We also remember Christian Ministries in a special way, that the Lord will continue to save and add to the church daily such as should be saved. And also, too, let us pray for one another on our individual struggles, our individual fights. Amen. If you're serving the Lord, you're engaged in a fight. You're engaged in a fight just because that you're serving the Lord.
And the Bible tells us that the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God through the pulling down of strongholds. So let us pray one for another as we, he said, if you don't suffer with me, you can't reign with me. Amen. So we thank God that we can count it all joy when we fall into diverse temptations. Any other prayer requests?
Yes.
Yes.
Continue prayer for LaTanya. She texted me and said she was, you know, she was sick. She said she was feeling very sick. So
yes.
Pray for her that the Lord would touch her body, give her complete deliverance. And as you stated, Bishop, pray for Christian Ministries. Pray for our pastor.
Yes.
That the Lord would encourage his heart and uplift his spirit, that he'll give him the patience, whatever it is, whatever it takes to deal with us as his sheep or his flock. Pray for the body of Christ, not just here at Christian Ministry. It's a lot of division in the church where people have their own little groups and they think because I got my church is more saved than your church. And pray for us as the body of Christ as a whole, that God will give us that unity and that love that he's calling for. And pray for this white couple that used to come to our church, Amanda, and I think the husband's name was Robert.
Yes.
Pray for them. They've been in my mind quite a bit lately, so I don't know what's going on with them, but pray for them that God will touch their minds, give them a mind to be saved or come back to the church, whatever's necessary, whatever God is calling for them to do. Pray for them that God will help them. Continue praying for our children. You know, we raise our children a certain way, but we have no control over what they do or how they act as they get older, get grown. So pray for them that God will touch their minds and save them before it's too late.
Yes. Amen. Amen. That much is true. All right, we're going to ask the church to stand. Thank you, Lord. Let every heart pray. Oh, gracious Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, we come before you, Lord. We say thank you. And we praise you for your grace, your mercy, your love, and your kindness. We thank you, Lord, for your anointing. We thank you for your goodness and your mercy, the love that you've shown toward each and every one of us. We give you glory, honor, and praise in the name of Jesus. Lord Jesus, have your way in our service on today and even in our lives. We ask you, Lord, that you bless each and every request that's been made known to you, Lord. We need your help. We need deliverance. We need strength. Bless our children, Lord. Bless our loved ones. Bless our family members. Lord, have your way in the name of Jesus. And Lord, even those that are in trouble, those that are in struggling, those that are sick in their bodies, those, Lord, that are bereaved, we ask you, Lord, to send forth your comfort, send forth your strength, send forth a peace that passes all understanding in the name of Jesus. Let salvation and deliverance, Lord, hallelujah, let it be made known. Let it be made manifest. Father, we give you glory, we give you honor, we give you praise. Bless our Bible study on tonight. Let something be said and done to encourage us, to inspire our hearts. Amen. To drop our neck and to follow after thee. Father, we give you glory and honor. Lord, give us the door button. Strength, Lord. Jesus. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
The Bible says saints ought to always pray. And not to faint.
Amen.
Amen. Man ought to always pray. I want you to turn with me to a very familiar passage in the book of Psalms, Psalms 23. Amen. The 23rd division of Psalms. I'm sure that given time, you probably could quote this whole psalm. Amen. It's comprised of six verses. But these six verses are very powerful, as is the whole word of God, is very powerful and has brought a lot of encouragement and comfort to a lot of people in different areas and different times in their lives, you know. And as we look to Psalms 23, David is literally making known and manifesting, making known and manifesting what he has experienced himself as his relationship is with the Lord. And tonight, the Lord wants even us to ponder our relationship with him. And you know, it wouldn't be nothing wrong with you writing your own song as a praise and a testimony as to who and what the Lord has done for you. The reason why that's very important is because as we read this song, we look back on it in times of trouble, in times of struggle, and it brings us encouragement. It brings us strength. The reason why the Lord wants you to remember his testimonies is because in the time of trouble, it can bring you courage. It can bring you encouragement. It can bring you strength. And that's what we need to take the next step.
Yes.
Sometimes, you know, we go through a lot and you may want to throw in the towel. Thank you, Lord. But the Lord doesn't want you to throw in the towel. He just wants you to take the next step.
Yes.
He just wants you to keep on going. He just wants you to keep on moving.
Amen.
And in order for you to make that happen, you have to reflect back on the Lord. Amen. The Lord's testimonies are sure. The Lord's testimonies are steadfast. And I know in the book of Philippians, when Paul says forgetting those things that are behind, he's not talking about forgetting about the Lord's testimonies.
Yes.
He's talking about forgetting about your past failures and your past failures that led to destruction, your old lifestyle. The Lord wants you to leave your old lifestyle behind. But when you come over here when you come over here in the kingdom of God, God wants you to remember, amen, what he is doing in your life. And literally, also too, I mean, I'm trying to move on here, but nothing wrong with you setting up a memorial unto the Lord. When the Lord brought the children out of the land of Egypt and took them across the Red Sea, he had them build an altar in the middle of the Red Sea as a memorial unto him and to what he has done. When the Lord took him over the Jordan River, Joshua took him over there. He had them to gather 12 stones and to put them in a place wherein when their children ask, what meaneth those stones? He's telling them, you tell them what I have done. Amen. The Lord wants memorials in your life. Amen. So that when people ask you how you got over, you can say, my soul looks back and wonder how I got over. And it was the Lord who is strong and mighty. He's the one that brought me through. He's the one that brought me over. Amen. Hallelujah. You know, even I'm thinking in the book of St. Matthew, in the beginning of St. Matthew, it talks about genealogy from the time of, I'll go backwards. It talks about from the time of Adam to the time of Noah. Then it talks about from the time of Noah to Moses, and from the time of Moses to David, amen, to the time of David to Jesus Christ, amen. Those are markers, amen, that wherein the Lord has done something great, that the Lord has done something mighty. Man, he wants us to remember. Hallelujah. There should be markers in your life that you can look back and say, this is when the Lord has done something mighty. This is when the Lord has done something great for me. Amen? Hallelujah. So as we begin to look at this psalm, Psalm 23. Hallelujah. David wrote this psalm as a testimony for his own life and a testimony for us. And this particular psalm literally encouraged David in the time of trouble. When he went up against Goliath, he remembered, amen, how the Lord was with him. and encouraged him, strengthened him to take him over. Amen. We ought to remember, hallelujah, and be encouraged by the Lord because he's able to take us over. He's able to take us through. All right. So looking at Psalm 23 and verse number 1. Can we read that together? What does it say? The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. Jesus, he describes himself to us even as the good shepherd. Amen? The good shepherd. The good shepherd that literally layeth his life down for the sheep. He says that the hireling, those that are just in it for the fishes and loaves, when the wolves come, they run and flee because they are hired. They don't care about the sheep. The Lord cares about us. Amen?
Amen.
The Lord Jesus, he's a good shepherd. Amen? He's a good shepherd. You won't find none greater. In fact, Jesus said, those that came before me were thieves and robbers. Amen? They were perpetrators. Hallelujah. Jesus says, I'm the good shepherd. So David is reflecting on that. He said, notice, he said, the Lord is my shepherd. Notice he made it personal. When you walk with the Lord Jesus, you've got to make it personal. Amen? He's got to be, you got to belong to him, and he's got to belong to you. Amen? And there cannot be any division in your relationship with him. David said, the Lord is my shepherd. Now, a shepherd is one that careth for the sheep. Amen? He careth for the sheep. And not only does the shepherd lay down his life for the sheep, but he also provides for the sheep.
Yes, sir.
Amen? The Lord provides for us. He takes care of us. And in turn, we ought to know his voice. And he ought to know our voice. Amen? So when the Lord calls, we're able to respond. Amen? Now, in Israelite days, when they had multiple sheep, there were multiple shepherds, and they all shared a space. Amen? They all shared a space. And the shepherd that had sheep in that space, they when they got ready to go, they made a call out to their sheep. And their sheep heard their voice. And there could be 100 sheep in a sheepfold. But that shepherd would call his sheep, and 25 of them, I'm just saying, would come on out, amen, and begin to walk with that shepherd. Why? Because they knew the shepherd's voice.
Yes.
How did they know the shepherd's voice? Because they spent time with the shepherd.
Right.
Amen?
Amen?
They spent time with the shepherd. Amen. The shepherd raised them up, cared for them, nurtured them. Hallelujah. We have to spend time with Jesus.
Yes.
Amen. We have to allow him to nourish us up, to care for us. Amen. Hallelujah. Now, everything is not easy when you're walking with a shepherd. But the shepherd's job is to provide.
Yes.
The shepherd's job is to protect. Amen. And the sheep's job is simply to follow. Hallelujah. We ought to follow Jesus. Amen. We ought to follow the Lord. Why? Because he's a good shepherd. Hallelujah. You won't find none greater than him. You won't find none better than him. Are we not to follow after the Lord? Hallelujah. So David is saying, the Lord is my shepherd. My leader. Thank you, Lord. My provider. My deliverer. Amen? And he says, notice what he says. I shall not want. Amen. Why? Because the Lord is going to provide for all of his needs. Amen. Hallelujah. That's how we depend on Jesus. Let us go over, hold that for a second. Let us go over to the book of Psalms, Psalms 34. Hold that scripture there in Psalms 23 and 1. But we need to make a point here. Hallelujah. He says, the Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want. In Psalms 34, drop all the way down to verse number 9. Verse number 9. And I want to read verses 9 and 10. It says, oh, fear the Lord, ye his saints. That fear means to reverence him. To reverence him. Put him on a pedestal. For there is no want to them that reverence him. When you reverence the Lord and set him as Lord and honor what he says and live by what he says there is no want to them that what? That fear him, that reverence him. No want. He shall supply all of your needs. Not according to my riches. Y'all be broke. Thank you, Lord. But according to his riches. Amen. According to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus. Notice what he said. Then it says, verse number 10, the young lions do lack and suffer hunger. But they that what? Seek the Lord shall what? Amen. If we put our attention towards seeking the Lord, these are promises that the Lord has made to them that fear him and those that seek him, those that reverence him, those that put forth the mentality to seek him. He said, if you fear me and seek me, there shall what? They that seek the Lord shall not what? Not want any good thing. Amen? That's the Lord. That's him talking. Amen? Is he able to back what he says? Can the Lord lie? Hallelujah. The Lord cannot lie. Notice what he said. Go over then to Psalms 84. 84, hallelujah, and verse number 11. Will you have to say amen? It says, for the Lord God is as a sun and a shield. The Lord will give grace and glory. No good thing will he withhold to them that what? Amen. He will hold no good thing to them that walk upright. He won't hold no good thing to you from you. Notice what it says. The Lord God is a sun and a shield. The Lord will give grace and glory. No good thing will he withhold from them that walk upright. That's why David said, the Lord is my shepherd and I shall not want. He realized that the Lord has made some great and precious promises. When we realize that the Lord has made some great and precious promises and we walk upright, earlier I said, the job of the shepherd is to provide. The job of the sheep is to follow. Amen. If we follow him, he will lead us to provision. He will lead and guide us to where we have shall not have any lack. Where we shall have not any want. Amen. Why? Because he's always caring for the sheep. Hallelujah. You can depend on Jesus. You can trust in Jesus. Hallelujah. My God. Hallelujah. Let's go back over to the book of Psalms. Thank you, Jesus. He said, David said, the Lord is my shepherd, and I what? I shall not want. And that's conditional. I shall not want if I fear him, if I reverence him. I shall not want if I submit myself to him. Amen? If I shall not want if I walk in his ways. Conditional, isn't it? Hallelujah. You know, I'm just going to say this, that a lot of people read a lot of scriptures and they get disappointed because they don't follow them. They just read them and say and quote them, but when they don't live the lifestyle, then when the Lord doesn't perform the promise concerning the scripture, they get disappointed. They get discouraged. The Lord is always going to uphold his part. We've got to uphold our part so that the manifestation of the promise can happen. Amen? Hallelujah. You've got to do your part. Pastor Quinn got to do my part. The Lord is always going to do his part. He said, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. We just read in the scripture where it says, the Lord will provide for them that reverence him. Amen. Live a lifestyle that appreciates him. The Lord will provide for those that walk uprightly, those that live in his ways. Amen. The Lord is not obligated to take care of or to provide in this respect for those that don't put their trust in him, those that don't seek after him. Amen. This is what relationship is about. Hallelujah, my God. I want to trust God. Amen. I want to seek after him. Amen. I want to humble myself beneath the mighty hand of the Lord. Why? Because I know if I do that, he will exalt. If I have confidence in him, he will deliver me. In the time of trouble, he shall hide me in his pavilion. Amen. And he shall set me upon a rock, meaning he'll take you out of danger and put you in a high place. Amen. Hallelujah. But that with only with your eyes, you'll behold the reward of the wicked. Hallelujah. God is able. Hey, glory. Hallelujah. And you know, we have to look also at the Lord as a warrior. Amen. And the Lord wants to fight for you. The Lord wants to deliver you out of every distress, out of every trouble, out of every struggle. Thank you, Lord. And we have to realize that the Lord will fight. Amen. Hallelujah. And help us. And as the scripture says, and that right early. So the Bible says here in verse number 2, it says, he maketh me to lie down. In what? In green pastures. Read. Now he's talking about the Lord. And notice, he maketh me to lie down where? So he'll provide you a place for you to graze. Amen. For you to eat. Amen. Hallelujah. The Lord will provide for your natural needs. The scripture says, seek ye first. The kingdom of God and his righteousness and all these other things shall be added unto you. Sometimes we can live our lives in anxiety. We see things getting low. Money may be getting low. Food in the household may be getting low. Amen. Sometimes we may be wondering, Lord, when is my next coming? The Lord doesn't want you to worry about those things. Why? Because he'll always provide your next. Amen? He'll always lead you to a place where you can graze. He'll always see about you. Amen? Hallelujah. His eye, the scripture talks about is on the sparrow, but he's also watching over you. Amen. He tells you, he said, look at the lilies of the valley. Solomon wasn't even arrayed as beautiful as they were. But don't you think that the Lord is mindful even to clothe you? Isn't he concerned about you? Doesn't the Lord know you have need of these things? Hallelujah. That's why you can say he's a good shepherd. He's a good provider. He's a good way maker. Hallelujah, my God. We should live our life not in fear of want, because the Lord will provide. We should live our life in reverence and awe of him. Hallelujah. That's how we should live our life, in reverence and awe of him. Hallelujah. Notice what he said. He said, he maketh me to lie down in green pastures. Notice, he leadeth me. You've got to allow the Lord, and I'm talking about the Lord Jesus Christ, you've got to allow him to lead you. Amen? Lead you beside the still waters. He knows if we can go into this, sheep can't drink running water, they need to drink from still water. Amen? If they drink from running water, they're subject to drown. Amen? Thank you, Lord. And the Lord knows what type of grazing you need. The Lord knows when you need to be watered. Amen? And he knows how to lead and guide you to where you ought to be. So we ought to trust him. Amen? Lord, lead me. You know, in these last days, my God, hallelujah, I want the Holy Ghost to literally lead and guide me even the more. Amen? Even the more, because time is winding up. We're at the end. Hallelujah. We're at the end, and we need to depend more on the Holy Ghost. We need to depend more on the anointing of God. Why? Because time is winding up. We need to get a deeper relationship with the Holy Ghost. And I mean that. Hallelujah. If you got the Holy Ghost, treasure it. Value it. Hallelujah. And let it lead you and guide you into all truth. Now, I want to say this as well. You got the Holy Ghost, listen to the Holy Ghost. Amen? Listen to what the Holy Ghost is saying. Hallelujah. Because it's the spirit of truth. Amen? It's trying to lead you beside some still waters. Hallelujah. It's trying to lead you in those green pastures. Listen to it. My prayer, I was praying here today. I was saying, Lord, you know, just let me have some wisdom. Like you gave Solomon. Amen. And I'm saying to myself, Lord, and I was praying to the Lord. I said, Lord, I'm not even after those riches that you also blessed Solomon with, because I know that when you give me the wisdom, the riches will follow. But Lord, I need the wisdom. I need the wisdom right now. Hallelujah. I need that. Hallelujah. And the Lord will give me that if I pay attention. Amen. Because that's his will and that's his desire. The Lord will give it to us if we pay attention. But you've got to want it. You've got to desire it. Hallelujah. And God will provide. Hallelujah. I'm expecting my IQ to go up. glory. Hallelujah. Mother Davis?
Can you explain what you mean when you say pay attention? Would you pay attention?
The Holy Ghost, you'll be in a condition or a situation, and the Spirit of God will speak. Listen to his voice. Get to know its voice. Amen. When we're making decisions, when we're communing with and meditating on the Word of God, the Holy Ghost will speak to you. Amen. There's scripture that the Holy Ghost will repeat in our minds. We've got to pay attention.
Thank you, Lord, because there's a reason. Search out those scriptures that keep coming up in your mind. Not coming up just for no reason. It's coming up for a reason. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. All right? So he says, he maketh me to lie down where? Green pastures. And he what? Beside the still waters. Now notice, verse number 3. He says, he restoreth what? My soul. He restoreth my soul. Amen? And let's go over to Psalms 19. Psalms 19 and verse number 7. I'm not going to keep you too late tonight. I heard that there was a storm coming. It's moving this way. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. All right, Psalms 19 and verse number 7. Can we read it together?
The law
of the Lord is what? Perfect. Converting the soul. The testimony of the Lord is what? Sure. Making wise the simple. Now notice, it says the law of the Lord is what? It's complete. It's perfect. You can't add to it. You can't take away from it. Amen. And notice what it would do. It'll convert your soul. Amen. When it talks about he restores my soul, he converts us and restores us with his word. Amen? He sends his word to heal you. He sends his word to deliver you. Am I right? So when it says, he restoreth my soul, amen, he restores you by using his word. Amen? To encourage you, to strengthen you. Amen? Hallelujah. So you've got to be aware of the word of the Lord. Lord, send me a word. Send me a word. Send me a word so that I can be encouraged. Notice, then we talked about the testimony. The testimony of the Lord is what? Sure. When you, earlier I talked about the saints of God realizing the testimonies of God. When you meditate on the testimonies of God, even in your own life, amen? God's testimonies are sure. There's a solid rock there. And when you realize that, that can restore your strength, restore your faith, restore your soul. That's why we can't cast away our confidence, which have great recompense and reward. For we have need of what? Patience, that after we have done the will of God, we receive the promise of restoration. We receive the promise of deliverance. We receive the promise of help. Amen? Hallelujah. So live your life in hope and admiration of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Don't look to the left. Don't look to the right. Don't be discouraged. Hallelujah. Look to the Lord because he is your help. Hallelujah. Now notice what that scripture says. The law of the Lord is perfect, converting the soul. The testimony of the Lord is what? Sure. Making wise who? A simple person is a foolish person. God's testimonies will make you wise. Amen? Hallelujah. That's why we ought not to, as I quoted that scripture, cast away our confidence. That's why we ought not to take our testimony lightly. Because there's some wisdom in it. There's some deliverance in it. There's some power in it that has the ability to restore you. Amen. to build you up. Hallelujah. When you're out of the way, your heart gets discouraged. Think on what the Lord has done for you. Thank you, Lord. Think on the ways that the Lord has already made for you. Sometimes, let me just say this, then I've got to move on. Sometimes we get into a new trouble, a new difficulty, and we sometimes forget what the Lord has already brought us out of. And then our minds say, well, Lord, I know you brought me out of that in the past, but will you bring me out of this? We have to remember that the Lord is faithful. The Lord is not double-minded. He tells you not to be double-minded. He himself is not double-minded. He himself is not unstable in all of his ways. God, he's sure. Hallelujah. And he doesn't change. He's the same today, yesterday, and forever. Yes, he'll bring you out of that. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Yes, he'll see you through. Hallelujah. Deacon Phil, glory be to God.
He knew it was God that was giving him the wisdom, the strength, and knowledge in order for him to even be a shepherd.
Yes, absolutely. Absolutely. And go with me over here to Psalms 51 and 12. The Lord is in the business of restoration. He's in the business of restoring, renewing. Amen? He wants to do that for us on a daily basis, if we let him. Hallelujah. Notice, verse number 12. Psalms 51 and verse number 12, what does it say?
Restore to me.
Amen. We can lose our joy of salvation. But if we turn to the Lord and say, Lord, restore unto me the joy of my salvation, of thy salvation. Amen? And what he said? And do what?
Uphold
me with your anointing. Amen? Thank you, Lord. You don't have to go around because you're connected to Jesus in a broken kind of state. Amen? Sure, we get broken sometimes, but there should be some restoration. Amen? There should be some deliverance. You shouldn't spend years in a broken state over a broken situation that happened to you years ago. Amen? Hallelujah. Y'all don't hear me. Thank you, Lord. Yeah, there should be some deliverance there.
Yeah.
Amen? There should be some healing there. And if the healing and the deliverance hasn't taken place, then you need to re-examine your relationship with the Lord.
Amen.
Y'all with me? Thank you, Lord. There should be some healing in your life. I shouldn't be broken over things that happened in my life wherein it is affecting my walk with the Lord. There should be some restoration. There should be some deliverance. There should be some healing. Amen? Hallelujah. Because the Lord wants us to be whole. The Lord wants us to prosper. Amen? The Lord wants us to be delivered. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. He wants that for us. Amen? Thank you, Lord. All right, let's go back to Psalms. He said, he restored my soul. He leads me in the paths of what? Righteousness for his name's sake. Now notice, he restores us, and then he leads us. You've got to allow the Lord to lead you. To lead you where? In the paths of righteousness. Amen? That's all the Lord knows. He only knows righteousness. You should only know and desire righteousness. righteousness. Amen? And he does it for his name's sake. Why? Because we have the name of Jesus. We represent him. Amen? Lord, I want you to lead me and guide me in the paths of righteousness for your name's sake. Hallelujah. Because there's a name that there's no other name given under heaven whereby men must be saved other than the name of Jesus. Amen. There's power in that name. We're representatives of him because we have the name. Amen. Hallelujah. You know, what we ought to do is you know, call on the name more than we call on as that scripture say in the book of Isaiah, his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, amen, Mighty God, Prince of Peace, Everlasting Father. That's all well and good, amen. We can call on those names. But we ought to spend more time calling on the name Jesus. Lord, help me here. When you call on that name, you're speaking more in authority, more in power. The devils tremble at that name. Hallelujah. That's the name you want to drop. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. You don't want to pray in the one who's mighty. Lord, I pray in the name of the one who's mighty. I pray in the name of the one who's great. That's all well and good, but that ain't going to get you too much result. But what gets you the result is when you call Jesus. There's deliverance in Jesus. Amen? When you're in trouble, don't say, I pray in the name of him that's mighty, in the name of him that's wonderful, that's a counselor. That's all. That'll get you to a good feeling. But you want to call on the name Jesus. That's where there's power. That's where there's authority. Use that name more often. y'all understand what I'm saying? Walk in that name. Amen. Meditate on that name. Hallelujah. That's where every knee is going to bow. That's where every tongue is going to confess. That's where even the devils are going to tremble at that name. Amen? Hallelujah. You get heaven to line up with you when you call on that name. Amen?
Bishop.
Go ahead.
When you're calling on the name of Jesus, it's like you said, there's power and it's a certain amount of anointing.
Yes.
When you call on the name of Jesus. If you're not surrounded by the anointing, you don't have the anointing on you at that time, just keep calling it.
Yes.
The anointing will actually fall on you just by saying Jesus.
Just by saying Jesus. Yeah. Amen. Why? Because there's salvation in that name. That name really means salvation. Amen. Jehovah saves. Amen. And when you call on that name, hallelujah, just like you said, the anointing will fall on you. Power will come to you. Hallelujah. Why? Because there's deliverance in that name. Hallelujah. My God. That's the name you want to call. Thank you, Jesus. God honors that name. God honors. While you're teaching now, God honors that name. Amen. Hallelujah. My God. My God in heaven. Thank you, Jesus. Sometimes you're dealing with people. You say, hey, you know, and they might not even turn around. But you call them by their name, they'll turn around. Amen. Hallelujah. When you call the Lord by his name, you get his attention. And he'll show up with all power and all authority. Why? Because it's in that name. Amen. Use that name more often. Meditating on that name. Pray in that name. Amen. Rebuke the devil in that name. Amen. He'll do it for his name's sake. Hallelujah. He'll show up for you for his name's sake. Amen. Because you called on that name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Now notice what he said. David says, he says, verse number 4, he says, yea, though I walk through the what? The valley. Sometimes we got to walk through some valleys. Amen. Notice what he says. There though I walk through the valley of the shadow of what? Death. Sometimes it looks like a dead situation. Amen. Notice what he says. Though you're walking through those valleys, what? Don't fear any evil. Amen. Why? Amen. Thou art with me. The Lord is with us. If he's leading us and guiding us, even through some dark spaces, we don't have to fear because he's with us. Amen. Now let me say this. I want to say this and I want to make this clear. He's not talking about you straying away going on your own. Amen. He's talking about him leading you and guiding you into some rough places. He said, you don't have to fear because I'm with you. Amen. I'm with you. I'm with you to deliver you. I'm with you to bless you. Amen. I'm with you to cause you to triumph. Be more than a conqueror. Now, you out there on your own, apart from the Lord, and you suffering shipwreck after shipwreck, you can't blame that on the Lord. You can't say the Lord is with me. Why? Because you're suffering too much tragedy and you have left the shadow of his protection. There's a difference. Amen? And you know, maybe I shouldn't bring this up in Bible study, but this is one of my pet peeves. You know, a lot of people claim the promises of the Lord, but they don't live by his standard. Amen? To claim the promises of the Lord. It's conditional. You can't say all things work together for good to them that love. If you don't love the Lord and are be called according to his purpose. Amen? And he said, if you love me, you'll do what? Keep my commandments. Amen. That's proof of the love. Hallelujah. It's a difference, isn't it? Amen. Thank you, Jesus. But people think that the Lord is obligated to bless them because they call on him. Jesus said, in the last day, I'm going to say, depart from me, ye what? Worker of iniquity, I what? Never knew you. But Lord, didn't we preach in your name? Didn't we teach in your name? Amen. It's a difference. It's a difference. Hallelujah. And the Lord does not want us to be deceived. Amen. Be not deceived. God is not mocked. Whatsoever a man soweth, what? That shall he also reap. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. There's a lot of times the Bible says, the scripture says, for us to rejoice when people die. Precious is the death of his saints. Amen. But now, if the individual hasn't been living a righteous life, that's no time to rejoice. Amen. That's no time to say that death is precious in the sight of the Lord. Why? Because the lifestyle doesn't match up. And well, you may say, well, Pastor, maybe they're one of them 11th hour saints and got saved on their deathbed. I say amen. Amen. But when we're looking at the scripture and we're saying that precious is the death of the saints in the eyes of the Lord, we want to fulfill that scripture. We want to live a life that shows forth glory an honor unto the Lord. At my end, I don't want you to say, well, he lived a righteous life, but he got saved on his deathbed. You know, I mean, hey, that's all good, but what about that dash in between? He relived a raggedy life. You know what I'm saying? Some people may not care about that. But as a child of God, we ought to care about that.
That's it. Amen. That's it. Amen.
Amen. Aren't we ought to care about that?
Amen. Amen.
You ought to care about how you're going, what's going to be said at your funeral.
That's it.
Yes.
See what I'm saying? If you don't care, then you'll live any kind of way. You'll live any kind of way. You ought to care. Amen. Let your light shine. Amen. The Lord cares. Mother Davis?
Like you said, Bishop, I was talking to my children and my grandchildren, and I was letting them know I'm trying to live a legacy, whereas if the Lord sees fit for me to go to sleep, y'all don't have to get up and lie.
Right.
Tell the truth.
Tell the truth.
Let it be known that I tried to live holy.
Right.
You know, and I'm trying to live the life amongst you all, my children and my grandchildren, and everybody else that know me. I try to live the life where they can see that I am striving, trying to be saved.
Yes.
I told them, I said, you know, we should all have a legacy where we want to do right.
Yes.
Live a righteous life before God. So, you know, if something happened, you don't have to die all the time. People might have a special ceremony for you, you know, celebrating you in some way.
That's
the
truth.
You don't have to get up and lie. You can tell the truth.
Tell the truth.
Yeah. You know, a lot of times we get up and people die, or we have a ceremony or something. We get up, we have to tell lies to make it look good.
Looking good.
You know, because if you told the truth, they shouldn't even be here.
Right.
You know, they shouldn't even be celebrated. But, you know, live a life where you can tell the truth and it's a good life.
Absolutely. And that's what the Lord wants. Amen. Let your light shine before men, that they may see your good works and do what? Glorify your Father which is in heaven. Not making up stuff. Not leaving stuff out. Thank you, Lord. You follow me? Thank you, Jesus. That's what I'm saying. Well, we're on the same page. There's no difference between what we're saying. Amen. Live a lifestyle that is exemplary and is manifesting the power of God. Then ain't nobody got to lie. Amen. All would be true. You can't live this life on your own strength. Can't live this on your own power. Amen. All of that's going to be revealed. Amen. Hallelujah. They can live this life. Amen. Where in the end, even heaven has to say, well done, thy good and faithful servant. Enter ye into the joy of the Lord. Let that be your legacy. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Let that be the legacy. All right. Now, where we at? What verse we in? 4. Wow. He said, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will what? Fear no evil. Why? Because I'm walking. That's why we got on that verse. Because I'm walking with the Lord. When you're walking with the Lord, he tells you, don't fear sudden destruction. Amen. When the enemy comes up against you like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord will lift up a standard against you. Amen. The Lord is with thee. Hallelujah. He's thy shield. He's thy shade. Amen. He's thy keeper. So he says, when I walk through a valley that's connected with the shadow of death, why? Because thou art what? with me. Amen. He's with us while we're going through it. Now, I'm going to make it plain here. He's not talking about walking with sinners and keeping sinners. Amen. He's not talking about that. He's talking about the righteous, those that have made the Lord their shepherd. That's the difference. Amen. There was one guy. He was, he came to me for some, I don't know if it was relationship counseling or what, but he wanted to shack up. And I told him, I said, well, if you shack up, that relationship will never work out in the eyes of the Lord. Because the Lord ain't into that. Lord ain't into that. Lord ain't into that. Lord is into marriage. Amen. That's what he blesses. Marriage. He's into that. Thank you. See, some people want the Lord to be with them in their mess. They're messy. And I want the Lord to be with me. Amen. Lord ain't with that. Lord trying to bring you out of mess. Amen. Into righteousness. Into holiness. Amen. Amen. So notice what he said. He says, thy rod and thy staff, they what? Comfort me. Thou preparest the table before me where? In the presence of my enemies, and the Lord will take you. That's why we ought not fear our enemies. The Lord has to prepare a table before you in the presence of them. Amen? So you're going to be surrounded by your enemies. But notice what the Lord said. He anointed our head with what? Oil. He'll anoint you. And cause your cup to run over. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord. So in the face of danger, in the face of trouble, the Lord is going to anoint you in the presence of your enemies. Those that are out to get you. Those that are trying to do you evil. So when you got to deal with them, know that God is with you. Amen? That he has anointed you. Notice there. He says, thou preparest the table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil and my what? Cup runneth over. Now notice, verse number 6. He said, surely, what? Now, he came down. We got to get ready to go. We came down to the testimony. He said, surely, goodness and mercy, it shall do what?
Follow me.
Follow you. How long?
All the days
of your life. Notice what he said. And I will what? Dwell in the where? The house of the Lord for how long?
Forever.
We got to be encouraged, saints. Amen? Know that when we're walking with the Lord, we make the Lord our shepherd. He's going to provide. Amen? Won't he provide? Hallelujah. He'll provide so you shall not want. Amen? If we're walking with the Lord, he's going to want to lead you. And when he leads you, you've got to follow. Amen? When you're walking with the Lord, he may take you through some dangerous places. Amen? But he won't leave you. Well, right? He won't leave you. He won't forsake you. Amen? In fact, when it comes down to your enemy, he'll prepare you a table before them. He'll anoint your head with oil so that your cup will run over. Yes. Amen? Thank you, Lord. And then he says, surely. What? Goodness is mercy. His goodness. God's mercy. It's going to follow you. For how long? Do we believe that? Is it following you? Have you experienced God's goodness?
Yes.
Have you experienced God's mercy?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Amen. We're going to let you go. Father, I thank God for your pressing your way. Hallelujah. And we're going to pray that God give you a safe journey home. Amen. Thank you. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Got to be wise. Amen. Sister, First Lady. Amen. We certainly thank God for everybody that came out today. And just that little button at the bottom. Amen. We praise God for you. In Jesus' name, that little button at the bottom.
Oh, see, go play.
Amen. Yeah. Yes. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Praise God.
Push it.
Yep. Thank you.
Is it still on?
Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Amen. We praise God for you. In Jesus' name.